O Sheol. The cross. What comes to your mind when you see a cross? If you wear a cross, or you see someone wear a cross, does that mean they're a Christian? Does that mean they're born again? Does that mean they are living for God? Very good question, isn't it? Now the thing is, what is the cross? Is it a lucky charm? Now you'll find that there are atheists, even if you want to call them atheists, they're more agnostic than atheists. But for the sake of argument, let's just say atheists. And then your agnostics and all such, they'll wear a cross. That don't mean they're a Christian, now does it? You see people take a cross and kiss it. And you know, thinking of it as a lucky charm. Now, don't get me wrong. I understand, you know, I have a cross, you know, and stuff. To me, I understand what the symbol means to me. It's not my lucky charm. I don't need it as something to say that I'm a Christian or to, you know, think, or like to have it in a name tag, you know, you label that, paste it on, and you're stepping into some kind of meeting and says, hello, my name is, I don't have to have one say, hello, my name is, and I'm a Christian. I kind of wonder what people really know about the cross and understand what it's all about. Take up your cross. We've all heard that. Take up your cross. And motto, you don't even really, I mean, you in part know. But there's that one part, you know, just don't want the full knowledge of it. It's an ugly business. But that's the whole purpose of it, isn't it? All the sacrifices and things throughout time, stuff with the animal sacrifice, it wasn't meant to be pretty. You know, it was, but there was a reason. Because of man's sin. Because of two people's sin in the beginning, death had been passed on down. We all suffer death because of sin, decay and all this, because of sin. Think of it this way. You think God snapped his fingers and animal skins appeared out of nowhere and he clothed Adam and Eve? There was blood spilled in order to cover them. It wasn't for a permanent, didn't cover them at all. I mean, like, for instance, animal sacrifices only covered unintentional sins. It didn't cover, and then that was a temporary thing, because they were constantly having to do it. It was a temporary thing. It was a temporary solution until the ultimate Lamb, which is Christ, Jesus, came. Now please, I'm asking you, do not flip this off or anything, because I want to show you one or two clips of something. It's not pretty, and wasn't meant to be pretty. Alright? But the whole point of it is to get you to think. And I want you to take a look at it. Thank you.
I have heard how Christians long ago were brought before a tyrant's throne. They were told that he would spare their lives if they would renounce the name of Christ. But one by one they chose to die. The Son of God they would not deny, like a great angelic choir sings. I can almost hear their voices ring. I pledge allegiance to the Lamb with all my strength, with all I am. I will seek to honor His command. I pledge allegiance to the years have come, and the years have gone, but the cause of Jesus still goes on. Now the time has come to count the cost, to reject this world, and to embrace the cross. And till the trumpet sounds on that final day, let us proudly stand and let us boldly say, I pledge allegiance to the Lamb with all my strength. With all I am, I will seek to honor His commands. I pledge allegiance to the Lamb, to the Lamb of God, who bore my pain, who took my place, who wore my shame. I will seek to honor His commands. I pledge allegiance to the Lamb. I pledge allegiance to the Lamb with all my strength. With all I am, I will seek to honor His commands. I pledge allegiance to the Lamb. I pledge allegiance to, with all my strength, with all I am, I will seek to honor His commands. I
my sleep is gone, my heart is full of sorrow. I can't believe how much I've let you down. I dread the pain that waits for me tomorrow, when the sun reveals my broken dreams scattered on the ground. Please forgive me. Take the time to care for no sinner born of me, but you know I read in the Bible that old story, how he prayed for mine and your forgiveness while he was dying. I've let you down. I dread the pain that waits for me tomorrow, when the sun reveals my broken dreams scattered on the ground. Please forgive me. I need your grace to make it through. All I have is you, I'm at your mercy, and Lord, I'll serve you, yes, sir, until my dying day, and help others find the way, at your mercy, please forgive me. Take the time to care for no sinner born of me, but you know I read in the Bible that old story, how he prayed for mine and your forgiveness while he was dying. Serve you, yes. died for all the world, all the little boys and girls. He shed his blood to set us free. He gave his life for you.
Yes, Jesus loves me.
Christ is sign.